Okay, we're going to talk about linear approximations and differentials. Now, this all comes back to different ideas of what a derivative is. We've seen that a derivative is a limit. You can write that limit in terms of h or x minus a or x plus h. There are different ways to write the limit, but there was the limit that defined a derivative. We saw that it was a rate of change. We saw that it was the slope of a tangent line. We saw that it gave the best linear approximation to a function. And we saw that was a conversion factor. And that's we used this picture to understand the chain rule. We used rates of change to do a bunch of physics problems. Today, we're going to concentrate on the idea of a derivative giving you the best linear approximation to a function. So let's suppose that we've got a function that's differentiable. And we know that the derivative at a point A is, by definition, the limit of the change in y, that's f of x minus f of a, divided by the change in x, x minus a. Now, recall that what a limit means. A limit of this equals that means that whenever x is very close to a, this is very close to that. So whenever x is close to a, this ratio is close to f prime of a. So we can multiply both sides by x minus a and get that f of x minus f of a is very close to f prime of a times x minus a. And we can add f of a to both sides and get that f of x is very close to f of a plus f prime of a times x minus a. Okay. Now, remember this expression, f of a plus f prime of a times x minus a. See, here's a picture of what's going on. If we've got some curve, the actual curve is y equals f of x. The tangent line is going with a slope of f prime of a, and it goes to the point a, f of a. So if you write down what the equation of the tangent line is, it's given by exactly y equals this expression that we just talked about. The idea of a linear approximation is that whenever x is close to a, f of x is going to be close to the value on the tangent line. Okay, the curve is a little bit above the tangent line, but it's very, very close. This line does the best of any possible line in approximating this curve. Now, there are a bunch of different names for this. This is what gets confusing sometimes. The book talks about the linearization of f of a at a. That means the function that we've been talking about, the function whose value is f of a plus the derivative times x minus a. Okay, and y equals that was the tangent line. So when the book says that f of x is approximately l of x, that's the same thing as saying the original curve is really close to the tangent line. A different notation is in the language of differentials. Now, we've seen that the letter delta can be used to talk about the difference between an initial and a final value. So delta x is the value of x minus the value you started with. And delta y, or delta f, is the final value of y minus the value of y you started with. We'll define this new function, dx, to be the same thing as delta x. And dy will be the derivative times delta x. This is the same thing as f prime of a times x minus a. And that's the quantity that we're looking at. So when we say that delta y is approximately dy, that's the same thing as saying delta y is approximately f prime of a dx, or f of x minus f of a being approximately f prime of a dx, or f of x being approximately f of a plus f prime of a times x minus a. It's the same approximation, just a slightly different notation. Some people talk about linear approximations with this formula. Some people talk about differentials, and it all means the same thing. In the next video, we're going to do some examples, and I'm going to show you how to do the examples and how to write it in terms of linear approximations, and how to write it in terms of differentials. So whichever notation is your favorite, you can do it that way.